free today, we can sure use it. First off, I'd like to read a thank you card that we got from West End Food Pantry. And this is one of the groups that our investments, the money interest that comes in from our investments, goes to these groups. And they got $400 from our church. And they say, thank you so much for your continued support, the directors and volunteers of West End Food Pantry. Just so everyone knows that these things are happening. Looking at the week ahead, Tuesday and Thursday, office hours 11-3. Today, the script orders are delivered, and I think Monica has something to say.
Yes, so next week is the last Sunday, and the last Sunday is always Valor. So at Memorial Day, if you remember, we did a fruit tray and a veggie tray for them, and they seem to like that. Sometimes with the holiday weekend, they're in and out, so it was something that they could nibble on. Sometimes they will have a little cookout because it's a holiday weekend for themselves, so that makes like a nice side dish for them. So what we're looking at is a fruit and veggie tray. So we're looking for things like broccoli, cauliflower, cherry tomatoes, baby carrots, celery sticks, rainbow pepper strips. For fruit, they can only have like low sugar fruits, so a lot of berries, strawberries, raspberries, blueberries, blackberries, and green apple slices they can have as well. And then veggie dip, fruit dip, and gluten-free dessert. Those, they're on the back counter to the left of the clock. We have them there. If you're able to donate any of those things, there's a card about bringing them back next week. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Monica. Thanks for all you do. And 11 o'clock today, we have a faith formation meeting. Is that correct?
Yes.
Yes, correct. Thank you. Yeah, and Amanda will be in charge of that. Looking ahead at this week, choir rehearsal starts on Tuesday.
Tuesday, right. Yep.
It has it here Wednesday. I don't know why.
Oh, and I thought that was corrected. It's Tuesday in the bullet.
It's Tuesday, yes.
Yeah, it's Tuesday in the bullet.
Okay.
Yes.
It's Tuesday at 7 p.m.
That's right.
And we can't wait to be back.
Come on out. Come on out.
Anyone that wishes to join our gentle choir, please come on out. We have a wonderful time. Let's see here. Sunday the 28th, the Valor dinner will be delivered. Any first-time guests with us today? Raise your hand, please. There, okay. Susie, do we have a gift for our first time guest, please?
Go back.
Susie will bring you a gift. Thank you, Susie.
Oh, I got it.
Thank you, Jim.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Okay, today after church, we need help in the fellowship hall. We need help. And everything is being removed because this afternoon they're going to come in and they're going to strip and start waxing on the floor. And that will take place this afternoon, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. I don't think Mary Storm's here today, but she is still looking for people to help with the ONA. Everybody knows what ONA is. Open and affirming? And what does that mean? Open and affirming. That is, we are open and affirming to anybody in our church. Doesn't matter their creed, their color, their race, their sexuality. And she is doing a whole series on that. So we look forward to it. And I know some people have stepped up to the plate. But we still need other people, and if you want to help with that, please contact Mary Storm. Rata Cutlery, we've just got another $81 check from them. Thank you for everyone that's ordering the cutlery. That's all going to the organ fund. And I think our organ fund is about maybe $12,000 at this point. And the fundraising for the sportsman's night, the profit after everything was probably around $7,500. So let's thank everybody. Upcoming events in the life of the church. I'm not going to read them all because they've been on the board, but there's a youth sleepover Friday the 26th from 6 p.m. until Saturday, August 27th at noon. And I will be in, and I'm going to make some pizza for these guys. Yeah, so it'll be a great time. Our outside service and picnic is September 18th. Anybody that needs to contact somebody, the team is made up of Mary Storm, Joe Conway III, Amanda Dieter, and Susie Close. College student information. There are forms in the back. Anyone that's going to college or an institution higher than high school this year, please fill out a form so we can keep them on our prayer chain. Grandparents Day, September the 11th. There's an envelope in the back. Grandparents Day, it doesn't matter if it's a grandparent or an aunt or an uncle, somebody that has been important in your life, put a dollar in there and we will put them in our bulletin. Thank you. Our guest speaker today is Reverend Dr. Becky Beckworth. Thank you for being with us today. Our guest organist again is Susan Riddle. Thank you, Susan. Always good to have you with us. Special music today will be by our choir director, Beth Kutzler. Can't wait to hear it, Beth. Wedding anniversaries. Mark and Tammy Schaefer, and I don't think Tammy's here today. That's anybody else celebrating a wedding anniversary this week? Thank you. Mission calendar for August is Bethany's Children's Home. The birthdays this week, the 21st. Wow, today. Reverend James Robison. And it is Pastor James' birthday today. He's on vacation. Judy Bollinger is the 24th. Susie Blows is the 25th. Happy birthday, Susie. And Gary Nelsfield, Robin's husband, is the 27th. Any other birthdays that I missed? Any other announcements for the good of the church? If not, let's prepare our hearts and minds for the worship.
We believe salvation is a gift of God, brought to us by grace and received by personal faith in our Lord Jesus Christ, whose precious blood was shed on Calvary for the forgiveness of our sins. Amen.
Right here.
Okay, let's all wait and say happy birthday to James.
Oh, hold on, guys. I'll pan the audience. All right. All right, ready?
Happy birthday! I'll be hearing about that. Please pray with me. God, may you use these words to touch hearts. May even these words make you smile. Amen. The woman in today's scripture is, she could be you. That woman could be me. Gender is not what this story is about. Perhaps instead, gender and the physical ailments that were going on were more of a metaphor. It doesn't matter if this woman was rich or poor. It doesn't matter where she lived or what she looked like. What matters is her story. me tell you what I do know about her. She isn't very important. I know that because we don't even know her name. She's a nobody. Kind of just another person in the worshiping crowd. Came to the synagogue on this particular day to worship God. And although she's bent over, we don't know why. We do know she is way bent over. We do know that she suffered some 18 years with some sort of ailment that has caused her to physically be bent over. Interesting fact about someone who is bent over. Everyone can see that. You see when somebody is having a physical problem with their back or whatever, and they are bent over. But whether you are crippled spiritually or emotionally, you kind of hide that with a smile on your face. But physically being bent over, everyone knows the woman has some problems, and what is seen cannot be unseen. So what bent her over? Maybe it was some of the things in life that she had to bear. Maybe they weighed her down. Do you know what it's like to have problems in your life? Maybe everything is going well for you now, and I hope it is, but life hasn't always been like that for you. Do you know what it is like to be weighed down by a social system? When you don't have the right education to get a job you'd like to have, but you can't even afford to get the right education, it's expensive. What about age? Anybody here getting older? Time seems to just go ahead, whether we like it or not. And along with aging come some pains and aches. But some people also have some preconceived notions about those who are older, don't they? About what somebody older can and can't do. Our scripture today is about Jesus who is teaching on the Sabbath, and he sees a woman who is bent in half. Her eyes are focused down and she's looking into the dirt. Jesus goes over to her. He lays his hands upon her. And immediately she stands up straight and tall and she begins praising God. She doesn't even stop to thank Jesus. It goes right to God. And the synagogue leader, he gets so angry. Jesus healing on the Sabbath, really? Why is he doing that? He doesn't question the fact that he's been able to make a woman who has been physically infirm for years and years. He doesn't question how on earth he was able to heal her. He doesn't do that. He wants to know what he thinks he's doing, healing on the Sabbath. Jesus released this woman from her pain, and her bent over body was now upright. And the leader got angry? Really? Now my sarcastic, snarky side questions this leader. What if it was his mother or his son? Would that have been different? The crowd? Love a crowd, they get all excited. They're so thrilled by what Jesus has done, that he has been able to heal this woman. And they start rejoicing too. They get all excited. They're excited about the wonderful things this Jesus is doing. And the synagogue leader is upset. He didn't question that Jesus was teaching. He questioned that he was healing on the Sabbath. And I get it. The Sabbath is important. We need to have a day of rest. We weren't built to work 24-7. We were to come together and we're to worship God whenever. But to ignore someone are in those facilities because it's could be healing? What about changing a baby's diaper? Now that's work sometimes. Do we take a day off of doing that? Or feeding pets or your family? It's work to cook. Of course, those things need to be done. And I think that's the point that Jesus is trying to make. Sabbath is a time when we intentionally take care of ourselves and spend time with God. But humans are not expected to just have it one single day. It may need to shift, but we need to be doing it. That's the important part. Worship and prayer time and more. We need God every day. And Sabbath can be any day of the week. If we are called to love Jesus and to love the way he loved, then it's clear that this story can be a model for who we should be as the church, the body of Christ. And not just on Sunday, but on every day. I loved all the noise going on here before worship starts. That's one of the ways I gauge health in a community. If you can't wait to see each other, can't wait to share stories, that shows a healthy church. It's because you're so excited to be together, but you're so excited to also be worshiping God. When we think about the people who come here and are dazed by help, what about those out in the world who aren't? Every day, we encounter the bent over woman. Every day. She just looks a little different. Let me describe some of the bent over women that I see. The woman or man, father or mother, who was up all night with the sick child. Child really is not feeling well, needs to go to a doctor. But in order to take the child to the doctor, mom or dad's going to have to miss work. And if mom and dad miss work, there's not going to be enough money for the rent this month. So the choices they need to make. Bend them over. And so next time you're in a doctor's office or you are in an ER, look around because the bent over woman is there. Someone who has been crippled down. What about the African-American man who is trying to get ahead, he's trying to be a good provider for his family, but roadblocks constantly appear, and he keeps hearing how, oh, the country has moved so far. So many laws have been made, and yet he continues to feel prejudice pressed upon him. The bent-over woman is the 15-year-old who has struggled with who he is. And he comes out to his parents and says he's gay. And his parents, they love and support him, and they're going to be there for him. But, you know, middle school, he gets a lot of teasing and harassment because he's different. And they belong to a church that says he's sinful. For him, life got too hard, and he isn't with us anymore. But there are more out there just like him, struggling. These are examples of people that Jesus loves. And they're not the only one. What about those of us who are weighed down by loneliness, by grief, by anxiety, by doubt? People who are having financial difficulties and not sure how they're going to get out of, or mental illness they can't quite explain to anyone else, or physical ailments or business troubles. We've got all sorts of things that are going on in society. And you know what? This bent over woman, she did not ask to be healed. She did not. She just appeared in the midst of And Jesus noticed her and reached out. And what did she get? Not only healing, but that woman got a sense of such incredible joy that she could do no other than to praise God. Joy came to her from knowing Jesus and his touch upon her life. Friends, we are not gathered here on each Sunday just because we enjoy each other's company. We are to gather because we hunger for the reign of God to be here. We long for healing and justice and love and acceptance. That's what the reign of God is about. We are here because we know we can't fix this world all by ourselves. It is when we come together that we get stronger. It is when we are there for one another and we allow people to be there for us. That is when God is working in the midst of everything. The relationship that God brings through knowing Jesus Christ brings incredible joy. And we need to be praying about it. Because if we are praying and we are working together and we are being there for each other, even when we don't understand each other, we can make a difference. We can stop looking down at the dirt and we can start looking up into the eyes of God. And we can be praising God. That's what we're called to be doing. And then we're going to see all of the differences. May it be so. Most Holy God, we thank you and we praise you this and every day. Your beauty surrounds us in nature. Your voice can be heard through ocean waves and the giggles of a child. Today we ask you to help us to rise up. May we each focus upward at you and away from negativity, from the things that hurt. Focus on the ways we can help. We pray for this, your world. May we work toward peaceful resolutions. May we find ways to feed the hungry, house the homeless, and ease the pain of those suffering. We pray for those who are homebound, for those who are saddened by loss, for the lonely. We especially lift up to you Amanda and Fiona, Marilyn, Sandy, Linda, Matthew. And we think about those who we care about and love, and the situations we're concerned about. And in this moment of silence, oh God, hear us as we silently pray to you what is on our minds and in our hearts. We give you thanks, oh God, for anniversaries and celebrations and birthdays and good times and summer days and picnics and all the joy that we can have with one another. We lift up those who are getting ready for school and those who have already started another year of education. Prayers for the teachers, the administrators, the cafeteria workers, the office workers. And God, prayers for each of us as we try to move forward in our lives, following your ways and Jesus' teachings. Now hear us, O God, as we unite our voice in the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray together, saying, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Mindful of the generosity of God and the awareness that all we have has been given, let us respond with the offerings of our lives and labor. Amen. Amen. Closing hymn, as I will sing the mercies of the Lord. have gathered together in this place to be family, community, to be church. Now it's time that we leave and we go back into the world, into our own individual lives, doing what God is calling us to do. May you experience God's love at the grocery store. May you know the healing of God that comes from the smile of a child. May you know that you are not alone. God walks each and every step with you, is there with every breath you take. Go and do good.